हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम स्नेहल फ्रॉम के वी सोसाइटीज बी सी कॉलेज निपा. ओके, सो इन द प्रीवियस सेशंस वी फोकस ऑन द पॉजिटिव टेस्टिंग एंड द एग्जांपल्स व्हिच आर बेस्ड ऑन द पॉजिटिव टेस्टिंग. सो इन दिस सेशन वी आर बेसिकली फोकसिंग ऑन द नेगेटिव टेस्टिंग एंड द एग्जांपल ऑन द नेगेटिव टेस्टिंग. सो नेगेटिव टेस्टिंग, so the negative testing, it is the process where the system should validate against the invalid input data. See, as the requirements based testing is there, we need to consider both the requirement, both the types of input data, whether it should be a valid input data or invalid input data, and we need to check as per that. So negative testing is the process where the system validate against the invalid input data. So a negative test checks if the application behaves as expected with its negative input. What it checks? It checks the application behaves as expected with its negative inputs. Means what? If we are developing an application, we need to think in a opposite way also. If by mistakenly a user is going to enter like this for that particular field, then what an error message should be get shown to that particular user, so that they will get clarify about that field and they will enter the data appropriately. So that is one of the type of a testing, and this is one of the negative testing, we can say that. So what a negative testing is going to checks if the application behaves as expected with its negative inputs, with its negative inputs. So the main intention of this testing is to check whether a software application is not showing an error when supposed to and showing a error when not supposed to. See, now understand it. What the main intention of this testing is, that it is going to check whether the software application not showing error when supposed to. It is not showing an error when supposed to. Means what? Here we are expecting the errors, but it is not showing an error. And showing a error when not supposed to. And in some places we are not expecting the error over there, but it is showing us error. Now that is the negative testing. Why? Because in the positive testing, what the main intention is there? In this we are going to check the software application not showing an error when not supposed to and showing an error when supposed to. It is same, but the meaning is different. Now see, in between that, where we are expected, it is showing the error. Where we are not expecting, there it is not showing the error. But here what it occurs, that here in that application software we are expecting the error, okay, but it is not showing. Where we are supposed to having an error within that, but that application is not showing us error. But and in some places we are not expecting the error, but it is not, we are not expecting the errors, but it is showing us error. Showing an error when not supposed to. So that is nothing but the negative software or the negative black box testing. Okay, so in this such a testing, now when we are considering this concept, now what is the bit in the positive? If we are expecting the error, it is showing the error. And where if we are not expecting the error, it is not showing error. But in the negative, what will get happen? We are not expecting the error, but it is showing. And somewhere in the some places we are expecting the error, but it is not showing error. So that is the main difference in between. So such a testing is to be carried out for keeping only the negative point of view. Where such a type of a testing is going to be carried out only to show the negative points of view, and only executes the test cases. And only executes the test cases for only the invalid set of a input data. Only for the invalid set of a input data. See, it is going to be carried out to keep the negative points of view only and execute the test cases only for the invalid input data. So that is the negative testing. So the negative testing is the testing process where we need to verify the inputs where the system is not designed, or we can say that unhandled input by providing the different invalid. Yes, see, what we are going to say, that This is the testing process. What we needed to identify, we are going to identify the inputs. Okay? Where the system is not designed, for that the system is not designed, or we can say that unhandled inputs by providing the different invalid input data. So that is the negative testing. It is a testing process, and we need to test it in a different invalid data, so that we can clarify or we can get a clear idea about the negative testing. So the main reason behind the negative testing is to check the, we can say that, a stability of the software application against the influences of the different variety of the incorrect validation data set. What where we are requiring, we are going to check the stability. Now the stability of what? A stability of software application. Now this stability of a software application is going to be checked against the influences of the different variety of the incorrect validation data set. So that is the negative testing. So what is the negative testing? A negative testing, it is the process where the system is going to be validated against the invalid data set. It is going to be validated against the invalid input data set. That is the negative testing. So the negative testing is going to check the application which is going to be behave as expected with its negative input. Okay, so this is the negative testing. So to more clearly understand on the negative testing, we are going to see the simple example on the negative testing. So now here again we need to consider some scenario. Okay, now consider the same above age text box example which we have seen for the positive testing. Okay, now consider the same above age text box example which supposed to accept only the integer values. Okay, so here suppose any person is going to provide the characters like A, B, C, D. Okay, here suppose if any person is going to enter the character like A, B, C, D in the age text box and check the behavior of the application. What we are going to check? We are going to check the behavior of an application. Okay, either it should show a validation error message for all the invalid input, okay, or for all the other than integer values, or the system should not allow to enter a non-integer value. Simply, what is expected? What is in that expected? What a requirement is going to say us that here in this age, okay, age means what? It is integer value. So what the requirement says us? It says us that here we are going to, or we needed to enter only the integer value. But meanwhile, suppose if what we begin happens, suppose any person is going to enter the characters. Now what are the characters? So for example, consider that the ABCD, okay, in the age text box. Now what it is going to check? It is going to check the behavior of an application. Either it should show us a validation error message, okay, for all the invalid inputs, or for all other than integer values, or the system should not allow to enter a non-integer value. So that is the basic things of the negative testing. So the negative testing helps to improve, okay, it is helps to improve the testing coverage of your software application under the test. Why? Because we are going to thinking in a negative way, in a negative manner. Okay, so both the positive and the negative testing approaches are equally important for making your application more readable and stable. Both are required. Why? Because we need to, for some type of requirement specification, we need to think in a positive scenario manner. For some set of requirements, we need to think in a negative scenario manner. So according to that, in such a way, we are going to develop a software applications which is having either a positive value or either a negative value. Okay, so let us take another example of the positive and the negative scenario. Now if the requirement is going to say that the password text field should accept, okay, password of an application is within that application again a simple text box is there. Now that text box is going to accept only the 6 to 20 characters only. Okay, a password text field. What it should accept? It accepts 6 to 20 characters and only the alphanumeric characters. Other than that, it should not get accepted. 6 to 20 means what? Below than 6, it should not allow us to enter over there. A system should not allow to enter the alphanumeric character, though they are alphanumeric, below 6. And below 20, above 20, it should not also get accepted. Why? Because if it is above 20, which means that we are crossing the limit. Why? Because we have set the limit over here, 6 to 20 characters, and that characters are alphanumeric. Alphanumeric means what? It is the combinations of characters plus numbers. It must be there. If it is not, a system should not allow to enter a value over there. So that is the negative testing. It is also one of the examples of your negative testing. Or positive and negative scenario. Both way you can think like that. So this is the negative testing. So what is the negative testing? A negative testing is the testing process where we are going to check for the invalid set of inputs. Okay? It is going to be checked for the invalid set of inputs or the invalid input data. For the negative scenarios, we are going to check. And for the example, you need to consider again an application is there, and within that applications we are having a simple text box. Now within that text box we needed to enter a age. What the requirement says is we need to enter only the integer values. But suppose by mistakenly any person is going to enter a character set, it should not be get accepted over there, or validation error message should be get displayed over there. That is nothing but the negative testing. That is nothing but the negative testing. Or one more example is what? The password character field. Where suppose we are giving a limit as 6 to 20, 4 to 20 or whatever it may be. It is depend on the developers as per their requirement, based on the customer's requirement. They are going to develop it. So this is the negative testing. So what is the positive testing? A positive testing is what? It is the process of testing where an application is going to be tested for the only valid sets of a data, valid set of a input data, valid sets of a data. Only positive scenarios will be get considered. And when it is a negative testing, we can say that it should only consider the negative sets of a data. Negative scenarios are there. Okay, so that is the negative testing which we are having. So there are the different scenarios of the positive and the negative test cases which we are going to focus or which we are going to learn in the next session. So this is the negative testing with its example. Okay, thank you.